Hi guys, Sajjad Hussain again with a new video. Actually, this is not a new video, it is in continuation with my other two videos. In my last two videos, I started modeling this building to design the column, and I followed PCA notes of ACI 31808. And the example was example number 11.1. In that example, the building was the data of the building was given, and I modeled the same building. The loads, vertical loads or gravity loads, were given. I added those loads, and the result of the wind was given, but actually wind parameters were not given. So I took a fictitious value. And in last video, what I did, I generated wind load on this building and I checked the design of the columns. Now I am going to add one more aspect of the generator, that is the seismic load generator of SAP2000. In this consideration, or in this example, I considered this building as a seismic category A building. So let us see. And if you remember, in one of my old models, I took the parameters for seismic category A building, and now I am going to follow, or I am going to use the same design parameters for this building, and let us see how the parameters are, seismic parameters are defined in this building in SAP2000. In last example, for wind load definition, I defined the constraint conditions. These 10 constraint conditions were defined. These constraint conditions will be used here also. So let us first define the seismic load. But before defining the seismic load, let us delete all these load combination, so that we will generate new load combination. Okay, now let us define load pattern. We are now defining earthquake load in X direction. The type of this load will be quake. And we will select the code from here. We will select IBC 2000. We can select IBC 2009 or 2006 because we are following ACI 31808. Now let us add this new load. Let us define the parameters here. So what we are going to do, we are going to modify the little load. Now this load and diaphragm eccentricity is given. This is in X direction. Eccentricity by default or for all diaphragm is 0.05. I am not changing. Otherwise we can override from here. We can add if there is any change in the eccentricity of the diaphragm or irregularity, we can add. But it is not there. So for all the diaphragm, by default, whatever eccentricity, 0.05 or 5% eccentricity is given. So I am using this one. The time period, well, we can use this one also. Let us define, because last time if in our model, so let's calculate the approximate period. So for that, suitable is this one, 0.02 and 0.75, because this is a concrete building and dual system. So this is the most appropriate selection. The response factor it will not be very effective over here because it will be falling in seismic category A. Now SS and S1, let us define SS and S1. Let's take the value of SS as 0.065 of G and S1 as 0.024 of G. Longest time period, well, 8 is okay. Site class is D. Okay. Similarly, we can define in Y direction also. Add new. Let's modify this load pattern. This is in global Y. It's okay. This was here 0.065 and 0.024. Site class was D. Okay. Now we have to define the masses also. So let us define the mass source. Okay, this is the mass source name. Let's modify. There are two options: element self mass and additional masses, or specified load pattern. We will specify the load pattern. We have already defined so many loads, so we know that dead load will be there. We know that superimposed dead load will be there. And we can assign, say for example, 25% of the live load. Similarly, 25% of the roof load also. So these are the masses which should be used. Now we can define the load combination. For concrete design, so now all the load combinations are defined over here. Okay, let us save this model. Let us analyze. Okay. Yeah. Run now. Now we can design the concrete structure 31808. This is seismic design category A. Rest are okay. Then load combination. So all the load combinations are there. Okay, let us design. It may take couple of minutes. because there are a lot of load combinations and a lot of members are there. Still we have to wait for some more time. Still some more time is needed. Now let's see. So we were looking for this column. So this column is designed. It says beam or column capacity ratio exceeds. That means we have to check. In flexure this is okay, but maybe in shear. This is the interaction diagram, joint shear, this is the beam column capacity. So the beam column capacity exceeds the limit. So here is the result. That means we should revise the size of the column. So actually that was not the purpose to design the column now, but the main purpose was to demonstrate the definition of seismic load for seismic category A building and check the result. Maybe in some other video when I will be designing some other seismic category structure like C or D, then we will see and we will rectify the model, or we will revise the section, or we will see what we can do. So hopefully this will be we can stop this model now, because they serve the main purpose. We wanted to learn the way the seismic parameters are defined in SAP2000. Hopefully you like my video. Thank you very much. Bye.